So as America marches into the abyss it voted for, talk turns to the Republican Party's future, if there is one. It's gotten to the point where you talk about the party's fate. It's like discussing the future of your senile aunt. You do it right in front of her. Here's Rand Paul. You know, I wonder if he would absolutely not run unless it were to win.
I would absolutely not run unless it were to win. Points have been made and we'll continue to make points, but I think the country really is ready for the narrative coming, a libertarian Republican narrative, also because we've been losing as a national party.
And there's Karl Rove. I wonder if he thinks Rand Paul had it right and that everybody has got a chance.
I think Rand Paul had it right. Everybody's got a chance. We believe in markets. Let people go in and participate. We should. It's just the opposite of Politburo. The more people who participate, the better off we are. The more we examine the quality of these candidates from top to bottom, the more likely we end up with fewer Christine O'Donnells and more Rand Paul.
Sexy man. Finally, Dr. Ben Carson. I bet he'd like to see more often in this nation an open and intelligent conversation, not just people casting aspersions at each other.
I would like to see more often in this nation is an open and intelligent conversation, not people just casting aspersions at each other. I mean, it's unbelievable to me the way people act like third graders.
Ben Carson for president. You're retiring as a surgeon this summer. What do you make of it? Are you going to get into politics?
It's not my intention to do that, but as I always say in every part of my life, I'll leave that up to God.
Look, here's what's needed in a nominee. Someone you don't have to explain. Someone who doesn't need me or you to defend his clumsy retorts. And I don't want a witch. Feel free to cast aspersions, but not spells. But I also want a fighter, a person who wants to win and won't roll over in a debate on Benghazi because a consultant told him to. I want someone who cheerfully destroys the liberal lie that achievement is selfish and that earning your keep means others will starve. And this person must realize he's fighting two fronts, the Democrats and the media, and the only way to beat them is to shine a light on them with humor. So to paraphrase Mark Twain, rumors of the Republican Party's death have been greatly exaggerated because the Republicans have one secret weapon, the Democrats. While we may have a different Republican savior every week, there is one constant we can all count on, the inherent bankruptcy of liberal ideas. Oh, and also that Joe Biden will say something really stupid. He's the best thing to happen to Republicans since Dana Perino.